Welcome to another TA Tech Tip. In this tech tip, we will discuss how to select the right geometries for testing solid samples on the Discovery Hybrid Rheometer. Rotational rheometers are commonly used for testing liquid or paste-like samples through conum plate and parallel plate geometries. The Discovery Hybrid Rheometer from TA Instruments offers the unique capability of testing solid samples with different dimensions as well as under different deformation modes. When studying the viscoelastic properties of solid samples, one of the most common rheological test methods is the dynamic temperature ramp. In this test, sample moduli and damping factor are monitored as a function of temperature, and the glass transition and subambient transition temperatures are determined. Selecting appropriate measurement geometry based on the sample's dimension and stiffness is critical to ensure a good and reliable result. Solid samples come in a wide range of materials, differing in their shape and stiffness. Here, we will look at options available for testing solid samples, ranging from stiff composites to soft foams. First of all, if you are working with medium to high stiffness thermoplastic or thermosetting polymeric materials, traditionally, these kind of samples are studied under shear deformation or torsional deformation mode using a torsional geometry. The Discovery Hybrid Rheometer can perform torsional tests on samples with either rectangular shape or cylindrical shape. In addition to standard torsional testing, the Discovery Hybrid Rheometer's integrated dynamic mechanical analysis capabilities also offers the ability to test samples under axial deformation mode. A full range of standard DMA geometries such as tension, compression, bending, and cantilever are available to perform DMA measurements on your rotational rheometer. For testing high stiffness composite bar sample, the three-point bending geometry is the best option, since this type of materials maintain their structural rigidity even at temperature above the glass transition point. Some materials tend to become relatively soft at temperatures above their glass transition. Examples include a sheet of rubber at room temperature or some thermoplastic materials at high temperatures. These type of samples will significantly sag during a temperature ramp experiment on three-point bending geometry. In these cases, the single or dual cantilever geometry offers an easy way to secure the sample and maintain its shape even at temperatures above the glass transition. For samples that are thin films or sheets less than half a millimeter in thickness, the film tension geometry can be used to perform the measurement in the tension mode. Finally, materials like foams or soft gels can be tested using the parallel plate geometry. With the parallel plate geometry, sample can be tested under the regular shear deformation mode. Using the Discovery Hybrid Rheometer equipped with the axial DMA capabilities, the same parallel plate geometry can also be used to test soft samples under compressive deformation as well. In this tech tip, we have discussed different options available for testing solid samples on the Discovery Hybrid Rheometer. Please stay tuned for more helpful TA tech tips, and thank you for your interest.